Hello, in this video tutorial I will introduce you to eDrawings API. eDrawing is a free application developed by SOLIDWORKS and allows to view and mark up SOLIDWORKS file without SOLIDWORKS being installed. We will create a simple C# Windows Forms application which will have a eDrawings control in it, and we will be able to open some files to view them in that application. Let's start by creating a new Visual Studio project. Select Visual C# Templates, Windows Forms application, specify the name of our project, so for example eDrawings WinForms, click OK and it will generate an empty project for us. The first step, I will add the eDrawings interop into my project. We can locate this file in the eDrawings installation folder, which is usually the common program files, eDrawings version, and it calls eDrawings interop eModel view control. Now we need to add this file to our project reference, so I can use a shift button while pressing the right mouse button on my file to activate the advanced window command, so I can copy that file path into my clipboard. Let's now add reference to our project file. Click add reference. I'm just going to click browse and just paste the path to the file I just copied. Click add. Now that reference is going to be added into my project. I would recommend to disable the option of embedding that interop, so you can just select the reference and set embed interop option to false. eDrawings API doesn't provide the control for .NET application. Instead, it provides the ActiveX control which can be used in managed code. So if you want to use it in Windows Forms or WPF applications, we need to create an ActiveX control wrapper. So let me just create a new file which is going to be a wrapper for our eDrawings control. I will create a new class file and I'll call it eDrawings host. I will need to inherit that class from axHostControl from System Windows Forms. And in the constructor, I need to pass the GUID of my ActiveX control into the parent class constructor. The GUID I'm using in this tutorial is a version independent GUID, so you can use it with any version of eDrawings. Underlying ActiveX control is not getting created immediately after constructor is called, rather it's created when the form is loaded and some initiation procedure is called. So the best place to invoke the getOCX method to get the pointer to ActiveX control is within the onCreateControl override of axHost class. Accessing the pointer to ActiveX control and invoking the APIs of eDrawings in the wrong spot may cause issues, so it could be either null reference or your control might be deadlocked. We'll add the event to this class which will notify external listeners that control is created and ready to be used. By some reasons, onCreateControl method is called multiple times, so I'm just going to use isLoaded toggle variable to only raise one event about eDrawings control is being created. AX control will not show up in our toolbox after we rebuild the project. So if I activate the toolbox, you will see that this control is not appearing. So it might be a bit complicated to use it on my Windows form. To address that issue, I'm going to create a user control wrapper. So let me just create a new user control and call it eDrawings user control. And this one will appear in my toolbox. So let me just rebuild to make sure that it works. So when I rebuild the project, you can see it appears in a toolbox. To host our eDrawings ActiveX onto the user control, we need to instantiate the eDrawings host class. We need to add this control into the controls collection of our user control. And I'm also going to handle the onControlLoaded event, and we'll just rebroadcast it to the listeners of eDrawings user control events. For some reasons, if I instantiate my ActiveX control in the constructor, and the Visual Studio designer throws an exception. So I'll show you what I mean a bit later. So I just renamed the variable to something a bit more meaningful and just rebuild the project to make sure everything works. And now let's just create a layout of our Windows form. So I like to use a table layout panel so my form design become responsive. So I'm just going to give it a name, TLP main, and I can just put it to fill the form. I'm going to add a text box for inputting the file name to open, and I'm going to add the button which is going to open my file in eDrawing Viewer. So I can use anchor option to align my controls. I can also change the sizing options for columns and rows of my table layout, so my form become responsive. So I'm just going to use auto size for second column, and also I'm going to use auto size for second row, so my text box and bottom become automatically aligned the way I wanted to. So if I resize the form now, you can see the controls stay aligned. And when I try to drag and drop a user control with drawings, I can see that exception as I was pointing before. So let's now fix that problem. The easiest way would be to defer the creation of ActiveX control into the separate function to be called explicitly from the form, rather than instantiating that from the constructor. So I can just create a new method and copy the code in there. Let's rebuild the project and drag and drop that drawings ActiveX control again. So now you can see there is no errors. I can just give it some name, something like control eDrawing. And also I can align my control to be filling the space. And I will just set the column span property to 2, so my control is aligned nicely in the Windows form. So next step, I'm just going to handle the event when my drawings control is created. I'm going to perform a small refactoring, just rename my method, also import some namespace, as well as declare the local variable, which is going to hold my pointer to a drawings control, and just set this variable within the handler of that method. As you remember, I deferred the initiation of the control, so the good place to call load drawings control method is within the onShown overload. So I just need to call the load drawings control from here, and that would instantiate the ActiveX control. Let's continue and implement the routine of opening the file. So I'll just double click on a button in the Windows form, which is going to create me a handler. I'm just going to rename it, and from that handler I just need to call the corresponding OpenDoc API from eDrawings control class. I just need to pass the value of my text box, and I also want to handle a couple of events from eDrawings control. So when document is loaded successfully and when document is failed, I'm just going to show the message box whenever it's opened. I will also display the error message box when document failed to load. I'm just like to use the same naming convention for my parameters, so I'm just going to rename those in the method. Let me put a couple of breakpoints in the code and run the project. So I'm just going to put it here when the control is loaded. Let's hit F5, so you can see our onShown method is hit. I'm going to init eDrawing, and this corresponding method is called, and event is raised, which means that eDrawing's control has been created, so I can just subscribe to events. It's going to put a breakpoint here on open. Now let's open a couple of Solr's files to see the demonstration. So I'm just going to navigate to the previous folder where I have some assembly structure. I'm just going to use the shift button to copy the path to that file. I can place it in my text box, just remove the quotes, click open, you can see that handle is hit, and API is called, and you can see that eDrawing file is loaded and message box is displayed. So I can resize my form, I can rotate and zoom the model. Let's open another SOLIDWORKS part file. So just copy the path and just paste it into the text box, click open, and you can see and the model has been reloaded. SOLIDWORKS eDrawings API can be used if you need to develop an application to quickly view SOLIDWORKS files, as well as, for example, printing them or marking them up. And it could be used for something like creating the PDFs in a batch without SOLIDWORKS instance via printing to PDF printer. So please follow the link in the description of this video for more information about eDrawings and use cases. Thank you for your time.